So here we are with my Arburg 221 injection molding machine. I got it a few years back and it's been sitting here in my garage for a year or so. So now it's time to get it up and running. It's originally from 1985, so almost 50 years ago. And I got an injection mold with it. It's supposed to make these small cups here. Unfortunately, it was dismounted when I got it, so I'll try to get it back in. And I have this crane over here, automotive motor crane, that I will try to put the injection mold back in. Also for power, it needs this three-phase power, so I'll need to mount that as well and see if I can get it up and running. Yeah, here's the mold, and as mentioned, should be making these small cups here. I think it's for a spray can or something that goes on top there. So of course now it's closed, and with a bracket on top there, I have this crane that I will try to lift it up and put it in here and mount it on the plates and connect the water cooling system as well. There's also a sprue heater that we need to put on. And I mounted a small controller box for that, so we can get power to that and control the temperature. I'll need to try to get a hold of all these buttons and what they do and all the small LEDs, what they mean. I already mapped out some of them. I have an old instruction manual, but hopefully I'll get it up running. All the settings should be for the form that they just dismounted before I got it. So, and of course I will need to pull in some pellets into the feeder there, and hopefully all the heating elements are still working. See if I can get a picture of those. Yes, in there. And on the back side, whoa, on the back side here, we'll have to mount this cooling unit to keep the water temperature at a certain level, and it all goes in here in these tubes, and the tubes go into the mold itself. So hopefully I can get this up and running. This could be fun. Okay. As the first step, I need to unfold my motor crane, engine crane here. And this has some long legs that goes down here and secured by these bolts or plugs. Same for the other side. So now I should be able to lift the engine up, the mold up. Usually you can raise it a little here first, like that. And it has 1,000 kilo in here, 750, 500, 250. And the mold there is around, 50 kilos or so. So we can make it the long reach here. Like that. Okay. And see if we can get it in here. And then hook in here. Like that. This one is secured. Let's see if we can raise this mold up. I'm just taking a measure here to see if we can actually get it in there afterwards. So maybe I'll need to take it a little lower. See, I'm worried that this one, I'm limited a little bit in my garage here. So maybe this one will get too high. So the distance to the mold maybe should be shorter. So I'll just lower it a little bit again. Yeah, that's it. And it takes a little while. See if we can get it in here. Check if we can lower it slightly. So I managed to get the mold in at one end, but yeah, as I remember, I actually need to fire up the machine to get the back there to move in. So before I can mount the other side of it. So right now it just sits there and I've tightened the screws, but not completely, because as I read it, you need to apply pressure first and then secure the mold completely with the screws. So no way around it. I need to put on power to this machine. I had a small problem over here. Actually, the cord for the controller unit and all the power for this machine. If we look up here, it's a little short. It cannot reach, so therefore I have prepared this extension cable, and I will need to apply that and put that on. So yeah, just a moment. So power cable is on, connected to the machine, plugged in. So all there's left to do is to actually switch it on. We have a main switch here. I can do that, and then on the side here we have the icon for the motor, and this is the one applying the hydraulic pressure. So this is what I'm going to switch on, and I think it will make a small noise, so let's hope you can still hear what I'm saying. Oh my god, that's noisy. That's the motor in here. And hopefully it's running the right way. You see here, if I just... So it's running this way. And this is what it's supposed to. So, don't need to change the phase there. And I'm not totally sure where we can see the oil pressure. Maybe on some of those. We'll let it run for a little while and then see if we can move the back plate in there so we can mount the rest of the mold. Okay, I hope you can still hear what I'm saying. Otherwise I would need to make it as a voiceover afterwards. But it's been running for like 5 minutes now. So hopefully there's enough pressure. I can't see anything on the gauges there, but definitely I hope these are for moving the mold or the back plate back and forth. But of course this one moves it in, but when I press it now, nothing happens, and that's obviously because the door is not closed. So when I close the door, let's try to push going inwards button here. And yes, it moves inward. I'll need to take care of the tubes coming out there on the side. It looks okay. Fortunately, I cannot open the door at the moment. I don't know if there's any way to make it slower, but this will have to do otherwise. Like that, small gap still there. Let me see if I can get the bolts in. Just taking one of the bolts here. Yes, goes in here. No? It's like nothing, no threat. And this is even one of the longer screws. So let me try down here. If there's a spot. Yeah. And there's a thread as well. I don't know why there's no thread on top there. Or maybe I didn't reach it enough. But let's try with another screw here. No, apparently it doesn't. So maybe on the other side. Yeah, that's a thread up here. And the other screw. Last one I have. So apparently not all screws were in here at that time. So at least now it's in. And maybe I can close the machine totally. Let's try to close the door again. And close the mold completely. It's closed. So I'll need to tighten those bolts. Let me just switch off the motor. Oh, that's so much better. Okay, so we got one bolt down there and two on the other side. And the top part of the mold is only attached by two. But these are the bolts that I had, so let me tighten these up. And we can remove the bracket on top here, see if we can open the mold. Tightening the one at the bottom here. Not enough. There's not. Oh. Yeah. Dropped it. Okay. Tightened the best I could, and now I just need to remove the bracket up there so we can open the mold and hopefully get it up and running. So the bracket is removed, the bolts are tightened. I didn't put on the heating element there yet, and not the water hoses. I just want to see if I can open the form now, or the mold. So I'll switch back on the hydraulic motor. Hopefully I have enough pressure to release the mold now. I'll try to push the button. I'll close the door, of course. Yes, it opens up. And if we go all the way back and if we are lucky, we should also have the ejection should be this one here to eject the part from the mold. See if we can get a picture of that when I push the button. You see the mold in there, and I'll try to push the button. Yeah, you see that fires the ejector, and actually that's the whole plate there that pops off the cup and When I close the mold again, it will go all the way in. Should be able to close the mold again. So how do we retract that? Maybe here. There you go. And then the mold is closed. So I'll just release the mold a little bit. Like that. And then switch off the oil pump. Yep. So the mold is mounted. And I think I'll attach the heating element up there. See if I can heat up the mold inlet. And of course the rest of the machine. Heating up the heating elements here. And see if I can get something out of this.